they would be weak in their legs. They would have weakness of energy. Because we are not doing the physical movement. We are not physically moving. And that's why I was just discussing with this earlier. That someone who is having depression, probably making that person walk is something which would be very good. Making that person do physical exercise would be very good. If you want to get out of negative emotions, that's why. Have you seen if you are having feeling low and you go for a 20-minute walk, then you feel better. Somehow you end up walking.
They make jokes about themselves. That's a defense mechanism.
And if you look at it, their body is a reflection of their defense mechanism as well. They need layers and layers and layers and layers to protect themselves. Not necessarily. That can be one of the cases, yes. A lot of times they could be. They need something to protect themselves. They're putting on layers and that gets reflected. It reflects in the body. It reflects in the emotions. They are laughing. That's also a defense mechanism.
It gets reflected. The underlying hidden emotion that is troubling them, which is making them binge, or it is making them stay inactive, or making them sleep for a long time.
Absolutely.
They don't want to face life.
Absolutely. And so the energy psychology is something which looks at all these three, the emotions, the energy and the body. So as I said, you can work, there are different traditions which work on very, very specific things. There are traditions which work only with energy, purely with energy, largely with energy. And they are able to change emotions, they're able to change body. You would know of such traditions. There are energy healing practices which work only with energy, largely with energy. There are traditions which work only on emotions. So there are, when I talk about emotions, I'll also include psychology here. This is where the psychology is. This is where the behavioral sciences are. Neuro-linguistic programming is. So what is done? Emotions are a resultant. The key to emotions is a lot to do with your language. So there are affirmations that you use. There are counselors who use the language. It's with the use of the language by which you can do the audit, you can do creative rephrasing of the whole thing. You can have creative affirmation, movement a lot of times. 40 years by there are books about positive thinking. Now we are talking about the secret. We are talking about how we speak. Because it's not a coincidence. What we speak, our language, is not different from our body, is not different from our energies. All of them are interlinked. Then there are traditions which talk only about body, that just keep working on the body. Have you ever been to those gymming people? People go to the gym, they think that's the end all and be all, and they are never down. They say, come on, you should exercise. You'll never be down. But there are a lot of things that they are even unable to do because they focus only on the body. Whereas in a lot of good traditions, all of these are combined. If you look at yogic tradition, we talk about yogasanas, we talk about pranayams, we talk about certain pratyahara and meditation practices. In the modern times, a lot of new scientists, the Western scientists, started looking at the East, and East was influenced by the psychology movement. And this whole new wave of energy psychology has come. Energy psychology, and a very specific part of it, that is EFT. What happens is, you combine your language and your energy mechanisms, the tapping points. There are meridian tapping techniques which work by using your language and your energy balancing systems. When you combine these two, what happens is that you get results on your emotions, you get your results on energy, and you get your results on your body. Energy, emotions, energy and motion, we started with that. We are back to that, energy in motion and reflecting in the body. What happens? Your natural state, constantly, joyful, peaceful, in movement, action-oriented, all of that. That's what your natural self is. And this is the energy. This is a very, very simple way of looking at it. It's not exactly how it happens, but this is how it. And then there is something that happens to you. Someone says something. There is a incidents which happens. Someone says something, you see something, someone insults you, someone fires you, someone does something. Something happens. And that incident, that situation, that event becomes a block in your energy. What happens is your energy gets blocked. Not just that it blocks the flow of the energy, but it gets entangled in a certain way in this incident. And we have seen a lot of times there are recurrent memories. We recurrently keep thinking about that particular word that person had spoken. We are never able to forget certain days in our life. Why is it? For a long time, the Western psychologists were confused because they would try to tackle all the past things and everything. They would try to tackle it only with this incident, talking about it, the language. They didn't know about the energy, they never tuned into it. Now that they have started tuning into it, they know that it is not just this to be removed, but this energy also needs to be freed. What happens in EFT is that we are able to separate these two. We work on the language.